The Children's Television Workshop is Sesame Street, show 962, produced in color in New York City at Reeves Teletech.
What's that?
Would you mind putting these in the mailbox for me? I got a lot of work to do in the shop.
Okay.
Would you?
Yeah, sure.
You're a buddy.
See you later.
Okay.
See you later.
Boy, you look like you got a lot of mail, too.
I sure do.
Can I help you?
No, no, I got it. I got it. I think
you
I can
sure?
make it. Yeah, I think I can do it. I think
Wait
I can make
a minute
it.
Here.
Well, okay.
Oh, yeah,
is that tucked in there?
I guess so.
Okay.
I hope you make it.
Oh, boy. Is that a lot of mail?
It sure
oh,
is.
Oh, boy, that's wonderful, and I'm just the person to help you. Well, I'm the new letter carrier here on Sesame Street, and I love my job. All day long, picking up letters and packages from people and delivering them to other people. Happy news, sad news, surprises, birthday presents.
In fact, that's great.
I was just about to open up the mailbox
well,
here
can
and
we, can
see
we
if there was some more mail in there.
Oh, yeah.
But I see you have some more mail.
Yes, and I see you have some mail in here.
Yes, and I'm going to put that mail right in my pouch when
well,
I take it out of the mailbox.
Can we put our packages in here?
Oh, would you please?
Yeah.
Sure.
There's nothing I love more than more mail.
Okay, well, you got a lot here.
You got
okay.
a lot of mail here.
Here's some more.
Here's some more.
Okay, we'll just put that right down
here.
Be careful.
We'll put it down there.
Okay.
Good. Yeah. Okay, that's fantastic. Now I'm going to open up the mailbox and see if there's even more mail in there.
Wait a minute. Oh my. Are you all right? Are you all right?
All right. I'm fantastic. This is the most mail I've ever collected. The very most mail. Look at all that. Oh, boy. There's a letter for Tulsa, Oklahoma. There's a package for Fairfax, Virginia.
Well, here's one to Beverly Hills.
Beverly Hills. Oh,
yeah.
Fantastic.
Wow.
Look at all this mail. This is the most mail I've ever seen. Thanks.
First you write your friend a letter with her name and address on it, then you drop it in the mailbox with a proper stamp upon it.
Then the postman comes along and gathers all the mail together, and he puts it in a pouch where it's protected from the weather.
Dooby 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 doo. It's on the way to the post office where it will stay for just
one day.
It's there to be sorted before it's transported away. Dooby 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 doo.
So by city and by zip code, they see where your letter's going, which is why you always send it with the address clearly showing.
And by number and by street, it's sorted out from all the others, so your friend will get your letter, not somebody else's mother.
Dooby 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 doo.
Then on,
we flow,
till the mailman is ready to go.
Through rain or snow,
through heat, sleet or hail, man, depend on the mailman to show.
Dooby 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 dooby.
While the mail is moving forward to its final destination, when your friend receives your letter, that a story's at an end. And it's amazing to consider all the different things that happen every time you send a letter to a friend. Dooby 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 doo.
Don't you know you're beautiful? Don't you know you're smart? Don't you know very sight is enough to light every corner of my heart? Don't you know that you're all the things you dream you want to be? When beautiful is how you think, that's what I see. Doesn't matter if your suit's not pressed or you don't have a brand new dress or you can't find a nickel in the pocket of your favorite jeans. Makes no difference if you're rich or poor. Those things don't matter anymore. It's how you think, how you live, how you love. That's all life means. Don't you know you're beautiful? Don't you know you're smart? Don't you know the very sight is enough to light every corner of my heart? Don't you know that you're all the things you dream you want to be? When beautiful is how you think, that's what I see. That's what I see, and I see beautiful.
The place, Roosevelt Franklin Stadium. The time, the 20th century. The game, headball. This is Showered Roselle reporting. Less than a minute remains on the scoreboard clock. Under the goalpost is the slow but steady Hardhead Henry Harris. The big question is, will Hardhead Henry answer his head ball question before time runs out?
Your question, Hardhead Henry Harris, is this. Do you get bread at a laundry, a shoemaker shop, or a bakery?
Let's see now, do they make bread in a laundry? No, I don't think so, because, you see, a laundry is where they wash clothes. And why would you make bread where you wash clothes at? So I would say no, they don't make bread in a laundry.
So far, that's right!
Now, let's see, do they make bread at the shoemaker's? Let me think about that.
Yes, Hardhead Henry Harris will think about that. But does he have time? Should he hurry up and perhaps make an unconscionable mistake? Or should he take his time and be right and score a thinker? Back to the action.
No. They fix shoes at the shoemaker, so why would they make bread there? No, I don't think they make bread at the shoemaker's.
That's right. Two, you are almost at a thinker. Move on.
Move on indeed. But will there be enough time? Will HHH change his style and rush to the finish? Or will he continue to slowly but surely use his head?
I'm going to slowly but surely use my head. Now, if they don't make bread at a laundry and they don't make bread at a shoemaker's, then the only question is, do they make bread at a bakery? Well, bread is baked. That's right. That's the way they make bread. They bake it. A bakery is where they bake things, like bread. So the answer is, yes, a bakery is where you make bread.
And just before time runs out, you have scored a thinker!
Absolutely correct. It is indeed a thinker.
I already said that, Showard.
Franklin Roosevelt, my humble apologies.
Roosevelt Franklin.
Of course.
Z.
Hey, you guys, come on, let's go over to Mr. Hooper's store and see if we can... Hi, Simon, how you doing?
Oh, hello, Susan.
Oh, hi, kid. You got a letter.
Yeah, it's from my cousin Sigmund. He's a card. He ought to be dealt with. Would you like to hear his letter?
Oh, yeah, because he always writes such interesting
letters. Yeah, they are interesting. Yeah, he says here, Dear Cousin Simon, let me tell you about my last job when I was a farmer in the country. First, I found some land and some wood, and I...
What's he doing with the wood?
Sawing.
Yeah, sawing.
It up, and then...
Hammering.
Good. It together and built myself a barn and farmhouse. Then, into the barn, I put some...
Chicken.
Good. And then I put a...
Oh, a cow.
All right.
Right, Percy.
Cow.
And a...
A sheep.
Mm-hmm.
Good. And
a horse.
Oh, I always wanted
yes.
Horse, yeah.
And the farm did very well. I sold the eggs that the... laid, and the milk
wait,
from
wait,
the...
Wait. Hmm? The what laid, you guys? No, they said...
Chicken's
legs, right.
Oh, and the milk from the...
Wow.
Good. And the soft woolly coat from the...
Sheep.
Yeah, lamb.
Yes. Then one night, I was lying in my bed, and what should begin to blow but a very strong...
Wind. Yeah.
Right. And the...
Wind?
Blew stronger and stronger, and before I knew it, the...
What is that? Wind, it's getting stronger.
It's windy.
Yeah.
Blew away the barn with the...
Chicken.
And...
Sheep.
And...
Horse, huh?
And in the morning, my whole farm was gone. Oh, so I've given up being a farmer.
Oh, that's kind of sad.
Sincerely, your loving cousin, Sig. Well, don't worry. There's more to the letter here.
Oh.
Yeah, it says, P.S. Now that I live in the city, I only have one animal to take care of. It's my little...
What's that? Yeah, probably a canary, that's what it sounds like.
Yep. Yeah. Well... Nice talking to you. So long, everybody.
Okay, bye-bye.
I got a real hot one for you. We're looking for things that are round. You know what round is, don't you? Well? Mm-hmm. You're looking good. That's it. Now, that's round. Now, I want you to look for all the round things. You look at that. There's a cantaloupe, and there's a melon, and... Oh, my goodness. Look. Oranges and... Boy, there must be about 100 round things out there, huh? Wow.
Why, what's the matter, little five?
I think I'm lost.
Well, how did that happen?
I came to the park with my big brother, and I started playing on the swings. And then I couldn't find him anywhere.
Maybe he's playing ball with those big boys over there. Say, fellas, would you come over here a moment, please?
Hi, what's up?
Is this your brother?
No, that's not him. My brother looks just like me, only bigger.
How about him?
Nope.
This him?
No.
Him?
No.
Here's another.
That's not him. Fred!
Hi, Frankie. Where you been?
Thank you. know what they are. They're hamburger buns.
Fur. I am covered with fur. From my snoot to my spur. I'm a furry fella. Fur. When you stroke it, I purr. When you poke it, I purr. It's maroon and yellow. Fur. Keeps you warm when it's purr. Don't you wish it you were? Fairly bursting with fur, fur, fur. Yes, fur is beautiful. Fur is clever. Furthermore, I'll love you forever. Fur. Unforgettable fur. Now you may find fur too frightful, but never switch. I find my fur delightful, but boy does it itch. You may see fur is horrible, I say no sir. To me my fur's adorable, and I'm covered with fur. I kind of grow it fur. Keep you warm when it's fur. Don't you wish it you were? Fairly bursting with fur, fur, fur. Yes, fur. Fabulous first rate fur, oh fur, unforgettable.
Fur. He's covered with fur.
Two, three, kick.
Ooch. From his snoot to his fur.
Two, three, four, three.
He's a furry fella.
Oh yeah.
Fur. When you stroke, he'll purr.
Okay, yeah.
When you poke, he'll purr.
Oh yeah.
It's maroon and yellow.
Before.
Fruit, red fruit.
Yeah.
Fruit, red fruit.
After.
Z. Zipper.
Oh, a butcher cuts up lots of meat to fix you what you want to eat. for a steak or chicken, spare ribs or a chop. Chop, you'll find them all right in my shop.
'Cause a butcher is a person in your neighborhood.
In your neighborhood.
He's in your neighborhood, yes.
A butcher is a person in your neighborhood. A person that you meet
each day.
Get it, meat. You get that?
Yeah, I got it the first time.
Feeding time.
Hey, look who's here now.
Time.
You must be the zookeeper.
Yeah, that's right.
Oh, that's terrific. You feed all the animals in the zoo, huh?
Well, not all of them. Yeah, I knew a guy once who fed the pigeons.
What's wrong with that?
Well, he fed them to the tigers.
You wouldn't be lying to me, would you?
Oh, I gotta tell that one to the hyenas. That's real good. Yeah.
You like that?
Oh, I go for that one.
Tell me about it.
Oh, a zookeeper keeps the animals fed. At night, he puts them all to bed. If you'd like to see me feed the kangaroo, just come and see me at the zoo.
'Cause the zookeeper is a person in your neighborhood.
In your neighborhood.
He's in your neighborhood.
And a butcher is a person in your neighborhood.
They're the people that you meet
when you're walking down the street. They're the people that you meet each day. That's very clever.
Yeah, thank you very much.
You're welcome. Was.
Cookie! Oh, boy, cookie for me, huh? Yeah, thank you. Oh, you eating cookie? Cookie not for me. Oh, cookie for me. You put it on table for me. Oh, thank you. Oh, cookie not for me. Cookie for you. Oh, cookie for me. Oh, boy, cookie. Get cookie on. Oh, boy, you like cookie, too. A chocolate cookie. You know what? You getting dressed all dirty. Give the cookie to me. Me no care if me fur get dirty. Oh, you still eating cookie, huh? Look delicious. Hey, got terrific idea. You eat cookie. When you finished, me give you a big kiss and the cookie off face, okay? Hey, I tell you what. You come home with me and we eat cookies all day. Got closet full of cookies. Yeah! Oh!
Come on, Ernie. Dinner's ready.
Okay, Bert. I'll be right along. Okay. Right after I have a couple of these cookies.
Hey, no, you ding-a-ling. No, you don't eat cookies before dinner. You eat them after dinner. They might spoil your appetite.
Right, Bert.
Okay.
I'll be right along. Right after I have a couple of these cookies.
Good. Hey, no. Wait a minute now. Hey, Ernie. Don't you know the difference between before and after?
Oh, sure, Bert. Yeah, I just as a... Well, I'm not so sure.
Yeah. Okay, well, now listen carefully, and I'll try and explain it to you, all right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now, you see, before you can have those cookies, you have to lift that cover.
Uh-huh.
Right. Now, after the cover is lifted, then you can have the cookies.
Right.
Right. Now you understand?
Well, let me see now. Make sure I understand it. Now, before I can have a cookie,
yeah?
I have to lift the cover.
Right.
Now, after I lift the cover, then I can have a cookie. Right.
Okay, now let's go to dinner, okay?
No. I'm not sure. I'm not sure that I got it absolutely straight. Now see if this is right.
Yeah.
Now before I can have a cookie,
yeah.
I have to lift the cover.
Right.
Now then after I lift the cover,
yeah.
Then I can have a cookie.
Okay, right. Now you know it, so let's go.
One more time. One more time, just to make sure, absolutely certain I got it right.
Okay? All right.
Now before I can have a cookie, I have to lift the cover.
Lift the cover.
After the cover is lifted, then I can have the fourth cookie.
Right. Okay, now you understand, so let's go and eat, all right?
Eat?
Yeah.
Gee, Bert, I'm not hungry now. You want a cookie, Bert?
Antes. Frutas frescas. Después.
In the first cage at the zoo, this is what you see.
One elephant drinking thirstily.
In the second cage at the zoo, this is what you see.
Two yawning hippos and one elephant drinking thirstily.
In the third cage at the zoo, this is what you see.
Three dancing bears, two yawning hippos, and one of them drinking thirstily.
In the fourth cage at the zoo, this is what you see.
Four restless lions, three dancing bears, two yawning hippos, and one of them drinking thirstily.
In the fifth cage at the zoo, this is what you see.
Five swinging chimps. Four restless lions, three dancing bears, two yawning hippos, and one elephant drinking thirstily.
Mama is me, so thank you.
dreams to come true.
Your dreams will come true.
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten.
Five.
Five. Five.
Ah!
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine.
Oh, Snuffy!
Hi,
what you doing?
Hi, Bird.
How's look, my pal?
Oh, fine, Bird. Look what I have here on the steps.
Oh, what are those?
They're stamps for my postcard, Bird.
Oh, they're nice and big. Gee, as a matter of fact, they give me an idea.
Oh?
Yeah, we could use those to play the game.
Bird. The game?
The game!
Oh, boy. One of these things is not like the others.
Right.
Which one is different, do you know? Can you tell me which thing is not like the others? And I'll tell you if it is so. Oh.
Well.
Gee, that's a tough one, Bird.
Yeah, it is. They all kind of look alike.
Yes.
They all have the same number on them. And they all have the same person?
That's true.
Isn't that Abraham Lincoln?
No, that's George Washington, Bird.
Oh, yeah. Well, I think I know. This one right here. It's too little. The others are all big.
Bird, I think you're right.
Now, what are you going to do with these
things? You're so smart. Would you help me, Bird?
Sure.
If you could carry one of the big stamps over to my postcard, then we can put it on.
Oh, sure.
And I can mail it. Oh, boy. Yeah, this it's right over one. Here, Bert, over this way.
Oh, okay.
Oh, here it is, Bert.
That is a big postcard.
I think first I have to lick the stamp.
Oh, yes. Okay. Well, here it is.
Oh, thank you. Yes. That should be
okay.
Enough, Bird.
And I'll stick it right here where it says, place stamp here. There. Whoops. Guess what? I've got my feathers glued under the stamp.
Oh, Bird. Does that mean I have to mail you, too?
I'll figure it out somehow.
Oh,
stops, it won't take time. Somebody come and play today. Somebody come with me and see the pleasure in the wind. Somebody see the time is getting late to begin. Somebody come and play. Somebody come and play today. Somebody come and be my friend and watch the sun till it rains again. Somebody come and play today.
CASA. 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 Mi casa. Casa.
Do you know the alphabet? You know the alphabet? I know the alphabet too. I know it starts with A. And then I get lost. Can you help me? What happens after A?
B.
B, and then after that?
C.
Yeah.
D.
Yeah.
E.
Yeah.
F.
Yeah. What comes after F? What comes after F? I know what comes after F. You ready? Oh, yeah. What's that?
G.
Ah, G comes after F. What comes after G? Well, I think I have another answer. How about that? What's that?
H.
H. H. Very good. Okay. Then what? H. I. J. Then what? K.
L.
L. Yeah? I know it's not easy.
M.
Hmm?
M.
L M
N
N
O
O O O O. What comes after O? Oh, we can do it. We can do it. What comes after O?
P.
P. P. Very good. P.
Q.
Q. R. R. Is that right? R. And
S.
S. S.
T.
T.
U.
U. We're getting there. What comes after you? V. V comes after you. U. V.
W.
W.
X.
X. I think we're going to do it. What comes next?
Y.
And then what?
Z.
Oh, we did it.
M. Nail. N.
I'm the mailman. I deliver mail by horseback deep in the Appalachian Mountains of Kentucky. The roads is rough. You can't get through it without walking or going horseback. And it's too far to walk, and I ride a horse. People wait for me. They know the days I'm coming, and they all glad to see me come, get their mail. The Pine Top Post Office is too far away for them to walk and get it. Carry the mail Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Winter, spring, summer, and fall. Sometimes I give children short rides on the road as I go along. It's a long mail route, 18 miles through these mountains. I have a long ways yet to go.
Are you looking at anything from above or upside down home? From the top or the bottom, in front or behind, are you turning it around?
Hi, Harry. What's the matter?
Oh, hi, David.
Hi.
Yeah, it's my cousin Barry Monster's birthday, and he's a rock collector, see? And I wanted to send him this rock for his birthday, but he lives in Ypsilanti, and that's a long way off. I don't know how to get it to him.
Well, that's easy. There's an easy way that you can get it.
Oh, yeah?
Yes. See, all you have to do...
Of course. Find someone going to Ypsilanti and ask him to deliver it to my cousin Bear. Oh, hey, anybody going to Ypsilanti?
Wait, that's not what I was thinking about. No. See, because very few people go to Ypsilanti.
Yeah.
Yes. No, though, see, there's a real easy way, you see. All you have to do...
Of course. This package is round. I can roll it to Ypsilanti. I'm so strong.
Don't roll it. You might knock down a building. Hold it. There is a really easy way. Look, see, let me hold it for just a second. Let me hold the rock.
Yeah.
See, it's already addressed to Barry Monster Ypsilanti, right?
Right.
Well, now, here, you hold that. And I just came back from the post office because I had to do something there. And I got these. This is going to help.
What's that?
These are stamps.
Stamps?
Yes. I'm going to drop and hold it. Okay.
Stamps.
Now, all you have to do is take the rock and
You're not going to eat those stamps.
Oh. No, I'm it's got to lick them and put that on there.
Why? Do they taste good?
No.
No.
Now, you see? Now, all you have to do is put it in the mailbox. Here, go ahead. Put
in
it in the
mailbox.
Fantastic. There.
Okay. That's all.
That's it. Now, you got to wait because in a few minutes, the postman's going to come by and he's going to take this down to the post office. You see?
Oh. David, I didn't want to cause them the trouble of having to come all the way here. No, I'll take the package down to the post office for them.
But it's inside the post box here.
The mailbox.
The mailbox. Oh,
David, you're absolutely right. Yeah.
What are you doing? Wait, don't.
Okay. Yeah, I'll just take the mailbox along too. Thanks for the information, David.
Here's a little something all of us can see each day. Now let's all take a look at it closer in every way. You'll see many things that you'd never believe were there. So come and look a little closer if you dare. Although there's so many tiny little parts that your eyes can see, you couldn't ever hope to guess what it's gonna turn out to be. Is it round or flat and skinny, square or short or tall? Close up, it doesn't look like what it is in any way at all. Did you guess what it is?
he's right.
Frog here, and in front of me I have four eggs. Let us count them, shall we? Okay, we shall. One egg, two eggs, three eggs, and four eggs. Okay, and together we have, I guess we have one less egg. So let's count the remaining three eggs, shall we? Okay, we have one, two, three. Okay, well, we have two eggs left. Let's count the two eggs, huh? Okay, we have one, two. I figured it might. Okay, we have one less egg, so let's count the one remaining egg, shall we? Here it is. One egg. Exactly. Okay, well, we don't have any eggs here, but what we do have here are four little chickens. Well, let's count the four little chickens, shall we? Okay, one little chicken, two little chickens, three little chickens, and four little chickens. And so how can I explain four when we have now one less chicken? So let's count the three chickens. One little chicken, two little chickens, and three little chickens. We have two chickens left. We will count the two chickens that are left. One little chicken, two little chickens. There is only one chicken left, and let's count it. One! Okay, we got no chickens and no eggs, so let's forget the whole thing.
Pelicans.
Scare. Learn to skate. Learn look for bait.
Well, Ernie, I'm really tired. It's time to go to sleep. Mm-hmm. Ernie, what are you doing?
I'm waiting. Tonight, I'm going to wait.
Wait? Well, what for wait? Wait, why? Why wait?
Well, you know that new guy, the guy who just moved in upstairs? Well, did you know that every single night he drops two shoes?
Two shoes?
Mm-hmm.
Well, sure he drops two shoes. How many expect him to drop? Four shoes? That's funny, huh? Oh, boy, Ernie, sometimes you're silly.
Well, he always wakes me up. So tonight I'm going to fool him. Tonight I'm going to wait until he's dropped his two shoes, and then I'm going to go to sleep.
Uh-huh. I see. Okay, Ernie, old buddy, you just do that. I'm going to go to bed, though. Get all comfy.
Hey, there it was, Bert. He just dropped his first shoe.
Yeah, good, Ernie. Now, will you go to bed, please?
Yeah, well, he should drop the second shoe in just a minute now. Just a minute.
Come on, Ernie. He's just not going to drop his other shoe tonight. Now, that's all. Just go to sleep.
Well, what do you mean he's not going to drop the other shoe? Hey, you know what? What he's waiting for is for us to fall asleep. See? But I think I'm going to fool him. See, what I'm going to do is I'm going to pretend I'm asleep. I won't really be asleep. I'll just pretend I'm asleep. And he'll think I'm asleep, and then he'll drop the shoe. Huh? There I go. Well, old Ernie's going to bed now. Here's old Ernie going to sleep. Off to beddy bye for Ernie. Yep, I'm really going to sleep now. Ah! Hey, there it was, Bert. Hey, Bert.
Wake up, Bert. I'm up. What's wrong? What's the matter? What?
It's okay, Bert. He just dropped his second shoe. Now you can go to sleep. Hey, Bert. Bert, are you going to sleep on the floor? Bert? Hey, Bert, you want a pillow?
Hi-ho, everybody. It's the ever-popular Letter on the Street interview show. Here's a likely-looking letter. Your name?
Ann.
How are you?
Nice.
Do you mind if I ask you some questions?
No.
Where are you from?
North.
Ever been on TV before?
Never.
You like it?
Nifty.
Would you like to say a few words?
Nod, nibble, new, night, now.
Thank you.
Nag, neat, nine, near, numb.
Thank you very
Nose,
much.
Nose, nickel, yeah. Number.
We're a little late, not folks, so bye-bye.
Nerve, new, net.
26 letters in the alphabet, and I got to get in.
How you doing, Mr. Mailman?
Oh, one at a time. Fills the basket.
Yeah, well, that's good.
You sure work hard.
Oh, just fine, yeah.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters N and Z, and by the number 5.
Oh, hey, Mr. Mailman.
Oh, howdy, howdy.
Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop. Goodbye.